Good afternoon. Welcome to St. Monica's. It's hard to believe that a year, in some ways, it's hard to believe that a year has gone by already since last Christmas. In other ways, it seems like forever. Amanda, in deciding the theme for her program, chose, I think, which is very appropriate for this year, we need a little Christmas. And when you think about it, it's sad to say, but this year there's no symphony, there's no Nutcracker, there's no choral society. So when we approached Father Schreck about if we could continue or to have the program this year, he said, most definitely. So we're thankful for that. I'd also like to thank Father Nagel, Father Schwartz, and Father Sizek. Before we begin, I'd like to start with a word of prayer. So in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Dear Lord, in the quiet stillness of this afternoon, we praise you. You are the Lord of our music, the author of all that creates the sounds. As we sing, we return to you in a many splendored display the gifts you have so generously poured out upon us. So often words cannot express the images of our hearts, and the wordless beauty of song praise raises to the heavens our deepest feelings. Music in itself is a most wondrous gift of praise. Thank you for the ears to hear it and the voices to lend it. Keep us always mindful, Lord, that we are here not so much to enjoy this gift for ourselves. We are here to give it away so that other ears might know what we know. Other spirits soar to the heights as ours have, and other hearts be touched by your love as ours have been touched. Amen. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. And now I turn it over to Amanda.
Thank you so much, everybody, for coming. As you know, if you've been to a concert before, this is my absolute favorite time of year. I would probably pay you to just sit here and listen to me sing Christmas songs because I love it that much. And now it's a little tricky. I'm doing something new that Noah taught me. I'm going to use my phone for music for the first four tracks. So I am not the most technically competent person in the world, so just bear with me. I think I know exactly what to do because Noah's a great teacher. So since I can't, well, it wouldn't be practical to come up and down and up and down between songs, I'm just going to do the first few just kind of back to back because I'm afraid I may mess something up if I try to stop and start. So as Randy said, we're going to start with We Need a Little Christmas, because my goodness, we desperately do, don't we? And then the second one is Christmas Waltz. All I have to say about that is it's just a precious song to me. I think it was actually written for Frank Sinatra, but I'm going to give it a try today. And then we have The Carpenters, Merry Christmas, Darling. I hope my papers are in the right order. That comes from growing up watching the Carpenters Christmas special. I thought Karen Carpenter had such a great voice, and that was always one of my favorites on that album, the Carpenters Christmas album. And then for Winter Wonderland and My Favorite Things, I have a special guest with me today who will be helping me on those two songs. So without further ado, let's get started.
Tree before my spirit falls again.
washing things, but deck the halls again now. For we need a little Christmas, right this very minute. Candles in the window, carols at the spinet. Yes, we need a little Christmas, right this very minute. It hasn't snowed a single flurry, but Santa dear, we're in a hurry. Climb down the chimney, turn on the brightest string of lights I've ever seen. Slice up the fruitcake, it's time we've hung some tinsel on that evergreen bough. For I've grown a little leaner, grown a little colder, grown a little sadder, grown a little older, and I need a little angel sitting on my shoulder. Need a little Christmas now.
I haven't grown a little leaner.
For we need a little music, need a little laughter, need a little singing, ringing through the rafter. Happy ever after, need a little Christmas now. Windowpanes, candles gleaming inside, painted candy canes on the tree. Santa's on his way, he's filled his sleigh with these.
sleigh bells and schnitzel with noodles, wild geese that fly with the moon on their wings. These are a few of my favorite things. Girls in white dresses with blue satin sashes, snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes, silver white winters that melt into springs. These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember my favorite things, and then brown paper packages tied up with strings. These are a few of my favorite things.
Cream-colored ponies and crisp apple strudels, doorbells and sleigh bells and schnitzel with noodles, wild geese that fly with the moon on their wings. These are a few of my favorite things.
Girls in white dresses with blue satin sashes, snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes, silver white winters that melt into springs. These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember my favorite things, and then
Thank you.
Now we get to get into what I think is just the beautiful part of Christmas. Now we're going to go from the lights and the warm fuzzies to the heart of it all, the birth of our Lord. And so we're going to start this. Oh, before I move on, I wanted to let you know that because of things being a little bit different this year, rather than collecting an offering or anything, there's a basket by the sanitary station here in the first aisle. If you'd like to make a donation, it'll go towards the church. But rather than pass it around, just to be safer, we'll just keep that basket there. So on your way out or at whenever you leave, if you wanted to make a donation, that's where we'll do that. So now, like I said, we get to the good part of Christmas. And an interesting thing about the author who wrote The Birthday of a King, William Howard Niedlinger, he was born, I think, in the 1860s, so he was around, I guess his heyday would have been the late 1800s, early 1900s, and he actually did a lot of things. He was an organist, he was a composer, he composed a couple of operas, he composed a mass, he opened a school for disabled children, and he taught music, he was an educator as well. And he also, one of his most famous educational pieces was Small Songs for Small Singers. And, but it just turns out that this may be the most known piece that he did, and I'm sure many of you are familiar with it, The Birthday of a King.
Hallelujah! How it rang!
The next song, I should confess, I've always been kind of enamored by Italy in general. I think it's because I studied music, and in studying classical music, I had to learn Italian and the Italian composers, and I love the Italian music and the art, and the people were so beautiful. And then, wouldn't you know, I end up marrying an Italian. So now I kind of feel like I've earned a little bit of Italian status. He's so handsome. And so what I've learned is that if you go to any church in Italy at Christmas, you will hear "Tu scendi dalle stelle," and that means the Christ child comes from heaven. So we're going to sing the traditional Italian "Tu scendi dalle stelle."
Più mi innamoro.
The next piece, it's a familiar Ave Maria. I'm not sure if all of you are familiar with it. It's attributed to Caccini, but it was actually written by Vladimir Vavilov. It's such a beautiful prayer, and it's so simple. It's Ave Maria, but I hope it will speak to you as you listen.
Thank you.
great solo by Randy.
Thank you.
The next piece is by one of my absolute favorite choral composers. I was so very much the choir girl in high school. I love being a part of our high school choir. I love choral music. I may love it definitely as much. I don't know if I love it more than performing by myself or not, but I love singing in a choir. And we had an incredible choir in high school. And my high school choir conductor, Miss Patty Barnes, was the first person that introduced me to John Rutter, and I've been a fan ever since. And he's famous more so probably for Christmas. I think I associate him with Christmas. He has some wonderful pieces across, in not just seasonal related, but his Christmas carols are just lovely. And this is one of my favorite pieces by John Rutter. It's called Christmas Lullaby.
Ave Maria, Ave Maria.
The next song, I Wonder As I Wonder, this was not a carol that was familiar to me growing up. I don't know if it's just not popular in Georgia or just me. I just didn't know it. Our church didn't do it. I don't know. But I heard it because we took piano lessons and we did Christmas recitals, and my sister played this as one of her pieces. And I didn't know the words at the time, but I thought the melody was just so hauntingly beautiful. And so then I learned the words, and I hope you like it as well.
I wonder as I wonder.
Concert with the traditional Ave Maria.
Oh,
for coming. I hope everybody has a wonderful Christmas, and I hope this lifted your heart and kind of got your spirit in the right direction. Thank you.